Story number 6. Can we really blame drugs and mental health for a rise in homelessness and crime? This is a big story to elaborate on because some people are in a different state of mind. So technically they have mental health issues. If I were not a victim of this myself in the past, or if I did not understand what happens when somebody becomes mentally disconnected from the surroundings around them, then I couldn't be able to relate or talk to you about this issue. But there was a woman, Emily Campagno, who says that Los Angeles homeless problems stems from drug addiction and mental health. So there's awareness being drawn to this issue. Then we heard the president touting out that gun violence comes from mental health patients, people who are mentally ill. We see this happening on a big scale now because people are starting to relate mental health to violence and homelessness and drugs. People who are mentally addicted to drugs or have substance abuse problems. So we're finding out that people are figuring out if you eliminate drugs and mental illness, you could probably have a more common, a better civilization. Some people don't know what to do with patients. Some people say they need to be medicated. The medication is expensive. Some people say that they just need there's all different types of beliefs when it comes to mental health concerns and mental health issues. But thanks to Emily for bringing it out and saying that her big goal for this report was to try to shine some light on the solution, which is homing in on what could be causing the problems. Did you know that most kids on Medicaid who are prescribed ADHD drugs don't get a proper follow-up? So now that they're finding out that mental health stems from child rearing and how a child is brought up, they're finding out that some of these children are not given the proper treatment. There are different beliefs around this topic. Some people say that if a child is not disciplined, or if it's just, there's all different types of beliefs. Some people say that we've become too of a cotton candy environment. Some people say that if we raise children to be more strict, to basically have better beliefs. Some people say that the belief in God, or God in the schools, or God in people's lives, the fear of God is what makes a child grow up to be stable. But these are theories. These are different beliefs that are starting to circulate. But can we blame drugs and mental health on the rise in crime and homelessness? That's the question, because people are committing acts of violence, mass shootings. But this has been going on throughout all of history, all of mankind. Violence, chaos, corruption. But there's always someone trying to find a way to patch these things up. Officials say a Philadelphia man who shot 6 officers should not have been on the street, period. So even when you look at the prison system, how do we stop prisons from being so heavily populated? These are stories that are popping up. And story number 6, why it has the ability to maneuver its way and stay alive. People are always talking about prison reform, people who break laws, and what they do to society when they break those laws. A mother says McDonald's worker would clean up a syringe in a bathroom. She's on the clock. She probably sees this as a hazard to her own health, the employee. She probably says, I'm not picking up this syringe. Somebody else says that, hey, this is your job. This is what you're supposed to do. So all of this falls into common sense thinking and how people are raised to believe. Some people say that, like this girl's common sense belief on the job, she's probably saying, but back in the day, workers probably wouldn't have had a problem cleaning up after somebody else's bad drug habit. So these are stories that are starting to surface and develop in this new culture, this new day and age, where some people says, I'm not putting my life on the line for somebody else's bad habits or somebody else's bad rearing of a child. So people are not going to take on the responsibility to try to get people back on the right track. This is why story number 6 has some substance. So who do we blame? Do we blame drugs, mental health, for the rise in homelessness and crime? And do we blame those who say, that's not my responsibility? Even if I'm getting paid, I'm not going to sit here and coddle somebody who has not been either raised properly, who has a drug problem, who has a mental health problem. That's their fault. So this is what we're starting to see happening. People are just becoming unsympathetic of people who have certain issues, certain problems, and people who decide to take on these problems. Just some of them are just bowing out and saying they don't want to do it anymore. Definitely happening in ministries. Definitely happening in psych wards. People who work in psychology. So these fields are need to be heavily populated with people who are qualified. And you're starting to see that the caretakers are starting to become exhausted. Story number 6 definitely has a lot of substance. I see it gaining some steam. Can we really blame drugs and mental health for a rise in homelessness and crime? You're the mediator with me, Brian West, where it is my duty every week to give you the top 8 headlines and developing news stories. If you yourself want to be a contributor, help out, all you have to do is visit www.method8inc.com, method8.com, where you can buy something, click on something, watch something, or just read something. Constantly reminding you every week that I'm just a mediator. The journalists, news outlets, people on the front lines always deserve the credit. I just stay in the middle, navigating over 200, probably more, 250 more, however many I can count stories a week, just for you to find those top stories that are beneficial to you. So if you want to be a contributor, all you have to do is visit www.method8inc.com, method80.com, where you can buy something, click on something, watch something, or just read something, or just sponsor a program. I'm here for you. Show me some love.
Have no fear, fellow citizens. Mediators